Science has mapped the female body for erogenous zones. In this video, I will give you the details which areas of the female body are most sensitive and which areas you better stay away from. One popular spot is a no-go area. Hello everybody, welcome to UroChannel. My name is Dr. Stefan Buntrock and I'm a board-certified urologist and specialist in sexual health. Just a few days ago, November 20th, 2024, an anatomic map of female erogenous and aversive sensation zones was published in the Journal of Sexual Medicine. I will link it in the description. 441 cisgender women with a mean age of 48.9 years plus minus 15.5 years answered an online questionnaire. They were given an anatomic illustration of the body. Their task was to point out their personal erogenous zones and their aversive zones. Aversive means that these are areas where they don't want to be touched. What's new about this research is that it included hitherto unexplored locations. The vagina and anal canal had not been studied in this way before. The study was conducted mainly in the US. Six large medical centers throughout the US participated, and one university center in Canada. It was their goal to come up with a reference reflecting the American female population. After reading it, I must say this research is an important step in understanding women's pleasure and discomfort, which is often underrepresented in medical studies. So, what did they find? The results might surprise you. Some widely thought of zones weren't as significant as expected. Finding number one, clitoris versus vaginal introitus. I bet you thought the clitoris would be one of the most erogenous spots on a woman. You're right. With a 9 out of 10, the clitoris was the highest rated structure. However, out of the three most frequently selected erogenous zones of the vulva, most women chose the entrance to the vagina first, followed by the area around the urethral opening, and then the clitoris. Finding number two, breast and nipple sensitivity. 57.8% responded that breast tissue was erogenous with a 7.9 out of 10. I'll spare you the standard deviations. If you're interested, you can look them up yourself. The nipples were the second most frequently selected, but the nipples were also the number one aversive spot. When this was the case, the women responded that they were either too sensitive or that touch even hurt. When it came to mapping internal zones, here's a finding that might surprise you. Despite cultural trends normalizing anal sexual practices, the anus was the most frequently reported aversive zone, with 34% of respondents identifying it as such. Reasons included: it's gross, 58.7%. It hurts, 33.3%, and I'm ashamed, embarrassed, 12%. But nevertheless, 12% reported it as erogenous. The main reasons were feelings of discomfort, pain, or embarrassment. Okay, so how about your favorite spot? Before I come to that, there is an important point I would like to raise. As in the real world, social media is competition for attention. When you have reached this part of the video, I have your attention. It means that you find the information worthy of being watched. So please, give me some applause if you like the video so far. In the digital world, applause means likes and subscriptions. To like and subscribe, it even takes less effort than clapping your hands. In 2024, 97% of my audience watched my videos without liking nor subscribing. So please, be polite. Do as you would in the real world. Show your appreciation for my work and subscribe. To all of you who are subscribers already, a big thank you for your support. So now, let's move to vaginal anatomy. I have a video out about the cervix. I received lots of comments claiming that women are keen on cervix hitting. This study reveals the opposite. The cervix was the most frequently selected aversive spot in the vaginal canal. Even if it only was the case in 6.8%, in plain English, this means some women didn't like cervix hitting. However, as I say in my video, not all women are equal. younger women were more likely to select the cervix as erogenous. So, what do you learn from this? Stop listening to technical sex advice on YouTube and start listening to your partner. They will tell you what they like and what they don't like. At least now you know that areas you thought of as a home run could turn out as no-go areas. Before this video ends, here's a bonus. Not surprising for those who know, the superficial and deep anterior vaginal wall were the most frequently selected erogenous spots. The anterior vaginal wall denotes the area upwards towards the belly button. This area has a name. You have heard this name many times before. The G-spot. For some scientists, it's a myth. For others, it's reality. Did you know it was named after Ernst Greifenberg, a gynecologist born in Adelebsen? Follow me on a hot summer's day into the village of Adelebsen in this video. By the way, it is located close to my office. And this video will give you even more background information about the G-spot. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.